Hey guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me today. I'm gonna go ahead and show you a neat little trick to remove very, very easily stuff like this piece of grass in front of the subject's eyes. So if you're new here, hi there, I'm Jess. I am a photographer person and I'm here to basically share stuff with you guys. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, click the bell icon and you will get notification every single time I upload a video. I upload every week and sometimes more than that if I feel like it and if I have time. So we've got this image of Bright here taken last night. She had just gone through bombing about through heather, hence why she's got all sorts of stuff on her head. This is relatively straight out of camera, a little bit of highlights down, a little bit of shadows up, that's kind of it. As you can see, we still have noise going on. I'm not that concerned about the noise in this image. If you wanted to, you could whiz this through Topaz Labs Denoise AI, which I've covered multiple times on the channel because I think it's legendary. If you want to know more about that, hit the link above, which I'll put up there. And if you can, please go ahead and use the link that will be in the description because they give me a couple of pennies if you buy it. I use it all the time. Okay, so back on track. We've got this grass piece, right, covering straight over Bright's eye. Now, this grass piece here is green. You can see that there is green, 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 right? So you can see a clear strip of green. And that actually helps us out. So you may go ahead and try and do some adjustments, which are 100% fine. And to do adjustments to correct that, you could add magenta, add blue, and just fine tune it to the point where you can get through it, and then add a curves to add contrast, all sorts of other stuff. I'm going to show you a quick way of basically whizzing it out that you may not have considered before. Now, this does not work for every single instance, but it's definitely worth a try because it's by far the quickest method. So what you want to go ahead and do is find a obviously coloured area of the object that's covering the subject. So for me, that's probably this bit down here, but you probably could go to, you know, this bit over here as well. Any of these areas are fine. This area up here is a little bit too faint for us to be able to get a good sample there. So I'm going to go ahead and use this bit here. What you then want to do is grab your eyedropper. So in Photoshop, if you just press I on the keyboard, that will get you your eyedropper. If you want to go the long way around, then I don't know why, but if you do, that's fine. Grab hold of the eyedropper tool and you want to just take a click point sample of this area. Now, you could set this to point sample, but I would prefer and would recommend a 5x5 average. That just means you want more pixels in there to pull a color from. So I'm going to pick that point there, which I have got. That color has been placed into my little color palette over here. And then I'm going to go down to the adjustment layers and select a solid color. What that does is that puts that green, the one that we literally just picked, on top of the whole image as a solid color layer. We're going to click OK on that. And we're going to go ahead and change the blend mode to, and this is important, subtract. Now, with subtract enabled, it all looks a bit strange. Don't panic. Click on the mask that is next to the green square. In your case, it might be a different color. Don't worry about it. Just click on the mask there. Then you want to invert it. We do this regularly here. Command I. Command I will invert that mask so that effect is actually not being applied anywhere on the layer at all. Then what we're going to go ahead and do is grab a brush. Keyboard shortcut for that is B. I do have a video of keyboard shortcuts. Well, I've got two videos of keyboard shortcuts. I'll link those above. They do speed up your life. If you want to go the long way around because, you know, you're that way inclined, go ahead and grab the brush tool. You want to go ahead and change the opacity up to 100, the flow to 100. You want the size to be, well, that's variable, but definitely hardness down to zero, so it's super soft. Now I change my brush size with, yep, keyboard shortcuts. So I will fine tune the actual size of that by using my keyboard shortcuts. That's beside the point though. Okay, so we've got a black mask, we've got our brush, we need a white paint because if you paint black on that, nothing's gonna happen. So we've got a white brush. And we go ahead and you want to just start painting over the areas of green, right? Don't panic if it looks strange. Try if you can to stay inside the lines. just want to go down. I'm not very good at staying inside the lines. Everybody knows that. And we just go down. And you can keep going all the way down if you want. You could take out all of those greeny bits too. I'm not fussy on that. You can do what you want. Okay. So when you think you've got that pretty much done, it doesn't have to be perfect right now. When you've got that pretty much done, you can have a look and see if there's any other areas of that colour that you want to target. So for me, there's a little bit here, really little bit. So I'm going to grab a brush. I'm going to go to maybe 20%. And I'm just going to add a dot or two there. Okay. So when I've done that, it looks like this, which looks like Bright, the dog, is trying to do some form of weird Zorro impression. Don't panic. Don't go ahead and change your opacity of the layer. Don't do that. Bad plan. What you need to do is open up the colour. So we're going to double click. And what that will do is open up our colour picker. So with the colour picker open on the screen, subtract works, the blend mode, subtract works in a really weird way. Okay. So you've just got to get your head around it. If you make the colour that you've picked darker, the blend mode will lighten on that area. So for me, this is obviously too dark compared to this. So what I need to do is make my actual colour darker, right? So it kind of works on an opposite. So if we want it lighter, we make it darker, okay? So that's looking pretty good now. This is still fine. We've got some green elements still hiding and peeking along through. So what we want to do is go and increase the saturation. So to increase the saturation, if we're on the hue here, increasing the saturation would be to shift right. Okay, you could click the S to shift to just the saturation view and then increase the little slider upwards there. That's totally up to you. I'm going to go ahead and do my normal way, which is to just grab it in the hue and shift right. So shifting right, what that does is that adds more of the opposite. Okay, so you can see that this part is going really quite blue, this bit's still staying a bit green. So I'm gonna just focus on this area here for now, and I'm gonna back off. So I'm quite happy with how that looks for now, okay? So I'm gonna click okay on that. Now we have some residual greens, everybody knows, I don't like residual greens. They're chilling over here. What I'm gonna do first though is touch up my mask. So I'm gonna click my mask, grab my brush, and I'm going to go with quite a small brush. 20% is still absolutely fine, but this time I'm going to go and basically tidy up these edges. So I've got a little bit of darker area here. I maybe want to take a little bit off of here. Basically just neaten stuff up. So I'm going to switch to black because I want to remove the effect from these areas. And I'm just going to dot in. Okay, so what that's doing essentially is it's just softening off the effect in that particular area. And that will help us because it will make it basically less obvious. So, tweaky, tweaky, tweak all the way down there. It's all good. And with that done, we've gone, you know, that far, which is pretty epic by most proportions. You could see that's a little bit blue. You can go ahead, double click, and remember, desaturating that will remove the blue. I'm probably happy with there for this part. Okay, so we still have this residual green. If you wanted to handle that, absolutely go for it. I'm not here to stop you on that. What I would do is grab the layer, duplicate it. So a command J to duplicate it. And that will apply the exact same thing all over again. We don't technically want that. So we're going to grab the brush and grab the mask. So grab the mask, we're going to get a brush, and we're going to be on a black brush because this part I was happy with. So I'm going to go to 100% opacity, and I'm going to go ahead and retake that back from that area. Okay, so with that done, I can then reduce the opacity of that overall layer to calm down the effect, or can go in and do our same adjustments again. So make it a little bit lighter, handle the greens a little bit more there by increasing the saturation. And somewhere around there is pretty good. So I'm going to soften off this effect down here because I don't think it needs to be on quite so strong. And you could heavy it up just a little bit in that little tiny patch. I'm going to go 20%. It's fine. and then I'll zoom out. So you could go to the ends of the earth doing this, but if we go ahead and group these two layers together and rename that grass removal, you can see we've been here before. What we end up with is a before and an after. Now, if you think that that area is too dark, remember your adjustment. So you can go back in to any of these layers, you can switch to brightness if it's easier for you, and just make it a little bit darker. Same with the other one. So a little bit darker. Actually, I'm gonna leave that where it was because I think that actually worked better. Okay, so now when we zoom out and look at the image as a whole, we can carry on with our edit. We might need to do a little bit of a desaturation process in some areas because of the color artifacts, but we've gone from green over the eye to no green over the eye. Green over the eye to no green over the eye. So give that a whirl, let me know how it goes. And remember, you can always add a mask to your main group, and that way you can go and add and remove this effect as you wish. So if we were to add a mask to the group, we can add a brush, big brush, 100% opacity on black to hide, and we can go and add that greenery straight back in there. So it could be that you just want it just off of the face, or you could want the entire strip out, whatever you wish you can have. So I hope that video is helpful for you. It's a bit of a strange one, definitely worth a practice because all these things help. You can also obviously set all that up as an action. I will drop the action for this into the membership community because I think it will be useful for you guys. So I'll have an action for you guys linked from the blog post below. That will be in your members area, and I'll see you all again really, really, really soon.